After the caribou and the rhino, we are moving to cow's universe. My name is Jean-François Collin. I'm a biostatistician for a pharmaceutical company that's called Civasanteliman Health Animal. So it's a company specialized in veterinary medical health products. And I'm going to present today an experience of using a Bayesian network for risk analysis on health status of dairy cows and trainers. So I'm going to explain a little bit what is the drive-off and how we did a Bayesian network analysis on two epidemiological studies that we did, one in France and one in Denmark. Okay. So it's not rocket science here. It's only a very simple example of a Bayesian network analysis. It's more to share how we use a Bayesian network on the study. So the objective of the epidemiologic study that we did is to assess the health status of dairy cows at drain-off. So we look at the occurrence of different clinical pathologies or subclinical indicators of pathologies during this period. So it might be hypocalcemia or hypophosphatemia. And we want to identify the risk factors associated with the emergence of those pathologies. So really, the goal is to acquire knowledge of what's going on around the diet of diet. There is an economical interest here for my company, but let's say that it's only for science that we did it, because I cannot disclose the information of the product we want to sell. So for the diagnosis period, lactating cows require a non-lactating rest period called a dry period prior to the calving in order to restore their body energy and their nutrient reserves. So here we have a lactating curve of the meat production. So here is the calving. And we can see that 4 weeks after the calving, there is a peak of milk production. And this level of production is determined by the dry period that is before the calving. So it's a very important period for the farmer to prepare the production level of the cow. So, how we did this epidemiological study? So, in France, we had 37 farms, in Denmark, 21. In those 37 farms, we had 500 cows that we followed, and 313 in Denmark. And so, it's a multi-center prospective cohort study, but with a low level of intervention because we took 7 blood samples of the cows, so it's a little bit interventional, but with a small effect. And so this is the health follow-up of the animals. So most of the parameters were recorded 7 days before the time period and 7 days after, but we follow the animals until calving to see if there are any occurrence of pathology. And we also had the record of the history of the animals before the drain-off. So we have a large amount of information for the study. So for the risk analysis, we select 61 variables, 27 that explain the farm characteristics, the management of the farm, the medical history. And on the animal level, we have 11 variables taken from the blood sample, chlorine, calcium, glucose, etc. And four variables for the milk control parameter, the proteic rate, the daily milk production, and 19 variables from the management management parameter, the method of try-off, if the cow were isolated from food, from water, the lactation ranking, etc. So a lot of variables. And we also ask the farmer what they do, what they think they do in terms of management, and after we collect the same information on the animal level, and after we will cross if there is a match between what they think they do and what they actually do on the field. So for the semi-hypocalcemia, that is our main response here that we want to look at. So the semi-hypocalcemia, we have two blood samples, one at the last milking for the during the dry-off, and one that is taken between 6 and 12 hours after the drying off. And if the calcium level at the second blood sample is below 2.2 micromolar per liter, we say that there is a sign of hypocalcemia, sub-hypocalcemia. So our target is a yes-no variable. And the predictive variable are the blood sample taken at BS1, at the first blood sample, and all farm and animal characteristics. So for the statistical analysis, the question is, there is many questions that we want to answer in this study, but the one that I present here is, what could increase the risk of semi-hypocalcemia? So we want to select the variables that are the most related to semi-hypocalcemia and characterize the relationships. So here it's a supervised analysis, but we are not interested in the model in itself. We really want to understand what's going on. So we use all the data here to build the model. We have some prior knowledge that we took from another disease, Lyme disease, and we extrapolate the assumption of this disease to semi-hypocalcemia. So we think that we thought that maybe the days in milk was a factor that can explain the hypocalcemia. The BHB is a blood sample parameter of a negative energetic balance. The lactation rank is the number of times a cow has been in lactation. And the method of dry-off, that could be gradual or short. So the dry-off method cross with any food or milking modification, and all farm management variables like the quantity of food, the quantity of water, the sleep, etc. So the Bayesian network analysis we've done is that we made an imputation with a structural EM algorithm, but we have a very low number of missing values, below 2, the overall percentage was below 2%. So we made a single imputation here. And we made an unsupervised analysis with unsupervised discretization. So we wanted to have a global network of all potential associations. First of all, to validate the quality of the variables, because we already know that some variables should be correlated, and we wanted to check that they are effectively correlated. So it's more to check the quality of the data, and also potentially to discover some associations. But we are really interested in the supervised analysis. So we made a supervised discretization with a decision tree on hypocalcemia. And here we compare different algorithms to check if we found the same network. And we also tried several structural coefficient analysis coefficients to detect several associations. And so here we search for the strongest probabilistic associations with hypocalcemia. And after we use a semi-supervised analysis here to search the association with the variable related to the At the end, we use the final network to characterize the relationship between hypocalcemia and the other parameter. And since it's a pharmaceutical company and we use a frequentist approach, we check all we found with descriptive statistics, classic Fisher test, GNM model assessment. And okay, so finally, we made an independent analysis of Denmark and France. And after, we're going to make a meta-analysis by putting the two sets of data. So here's the advantage of Bayesian network is that we can take into account the multifactorial problem we have. So we have a lot of explicative variables with potentially a lot of interactions. And the discretization of the numeric variables is very interesting here for the veterinary, because they want to see if we can find some threshold at which we can predict the hypocalcemia. And compared to other classical multifactorial approach, it's interesting because compared to a PCR, the communication is very reasonable. So here I'm going to present some part of Denmark results. So the sub-hypocalcemia statistics, we had 53 cows in sub-hypocalcemia in Denmark out of 344, so it represents around 50% of the population that in sub-hypocalcemia. Here is the unsupervised Bayesian network that we have on all the variables. There is many link, and so it's going to take a lot of time for the veterinarians to explore all this network. But we already can check that the quality of the variable is good, because for example here we have the milk production that is linked to the days in milk and to the number of eating days, for example. That is some associations that we already know that exist, so we can confirm that. And we can also see that the hypocalcemia, which is our target here, is related to the calcium level at PS2, which is related to the calcium level at PS1. But it's on the... not related to many variables in the network. So we can already know that there will probably not be a lot of relations to hypocalcemia. And when we do the supervised Bayesian analysis, we came with a very simple network with only finally two variables. So we try to lower the structural coefficient, we try to make a cross-validation, we try several algorithms. But this approach, we found the same network. So it's a very simple one. And what is interesting here is that it enables the removal of a lot of prior hypotheses. We thought that many variables were implied in hypocalcemia. But really, what we found is that hypocalcemia can be predicted by the calcium level at the time of. And it depends mainly on the milk production. So whatever the farm characteristics, the management of the animal, the biochemical characteristics, etc., there is only those two variables that we can use to predict the milk. And in the semi-supervised approach, we did not found any variables linked to the level of calcium. So that is very interesting. And the milk production, on the opposite, is can be explained by the farm identification, because depending on the farm, the milk production of the animal will not be the same, because there are many different ways to build a very different farm in Denmark. It's related to the breed of the animal. The glucose and the phosphate have a small effect, and it's interesting to see that the time that the animal stay without access to food has also an impact on the milk production. So with this network, we can have a profile of an animal in hypocalcemia. So we found this threshold that is interesting. The low lab level is at 2.40, and the discretization, there is those two thresholds. So an animal in hypocalcemia have a low level of calcium at drying off, and the hypocalcemic cow are related to whether a small producer of milk or high producer of milk. So here's the relationship strength between all parameters. And we can see that the hypocalcemia and the calcium level at base one is not on the top of the list, and it's the Pearson's correlation is not very high, and the milk production also is not a strong link with hypocalcemia compared to the milk production and the breed and the farming. But what is interesting is that we can now identify the risk of hypocalcemia if we know that if we have a cow with a calcium level below 2.50 micromole at base 1, the risk of hypocalcemia 12 hours later rise to 75%. And that is very interesting for the veterinary. And also that the low producer of milk are more at risk of hypocalcemia if they are below 917 kilograms, the risk of hypocalcemia increase up to 41%. And finally, if we have a risk at first at 15% of hypocalcemia, if we combine those two events, which has a low probability, joint probability, but if this event occurs, the risk of hypocalcemia is very high. So that's interesting for the veterinary. In France, we have only interimary results now, but we found almost the same network. It's mainly impacted by the level of calcium at base 1. So that's it for the results. So in this study, we can now know that we have reliable parameters. But the main parameter linked to hypocalcemia is the calcium level at drying off. And what is interesting is that we can quantify the risk of hypocalcemia by the level of calcium, the level of production, the breed, etc. So we have been able to remove many prior hypotheses. And now the results are still under interpretation because we have a lot of information in the data. And the meta-analysis is still. Thank you.
No cow videos.
Milking videos.
That's what we want.
So, if you have any critiques or comments on the way we analyze the data, I'm very interested.
Done any cross-validation
then? Yeah, yes. But we didn't found a popular link, interesting link, hypocalcemia.
Right. This was
like
a procedure. Final model predicted. How well did it do in predicting which cows?
We didn't check that.
Okay.
Yes.
Other questions? Well, in that case, thank you so much.
Thank you.